Stefan. Having a bit of tip trouble?
Oh, yes. Yeah, well, little devils, aren't they? I leave the tile out for the milkman, but he never puts it out with them.
May I have a word with him?
Certainly, Doctor. Would you like a cup of tea?
Yes, thank you, I'd love one.
In the kitchen, if you don't mind. I'm afraid the lounge is looking a bit like a motorway cafe at the moment.
Yes, must be a lot of work for you to do on your own, what with looking after your father as well.
Yeah, you can say that again, I'm knackered. Oh, now we have another teapot somewhere. Oh, yes, here we are. Hope this is all right. God, what has he done in this? I mean, you never know in this house. You'd be surprised some of the things what he puts in them. Would you care to sit down?
Thank you.
Would like to do your rounds without stuck on your trousers, would you? With the old bedside manner and stuff a bit, wouldn't you? I mean, masked with gem all over the cat and pain. Right then. And, how is my, aged Pete? Be able to get up soon, will you?
No, I'm afraid not.
Oh, how long do you think then?
Well, it's difficult to say, but he might be in bed for some considerable time.
What, all day? I'm sure you get up and do a bit of graft, can't
you? Oh, I'm afraid not for a long while. You see, your father's not getting any younger.
What's wrong with him?
Oh, it's his back. He's got some disc trouble. He's in great pain every time he moves.
They don't move all that much at the best of times.
The only effective remedy is complete bed rest.
I see. How long for?
Well, as I say, we don't know. It might take days. Might take weeks.
Weeks? I can't look out of him for weeks. I mean, I've got work to do. I can't do it. I mean, I'm shagged out of an eye when I get home as it is. I mean, I'm always falling asleep on a plank. If it wasn't for the horse knowing the way home, we'd never get here sunlight.
Sorry, Mr. Steptoe, but there really is nothing we can do except wait.
Ginger snaps or custard cream?
I do try and look on the bright side. You know, sometimes these things clear up overnight, just like that.
Oh, not with him. He'll hang it out. Look, if he's as bad as what you say he is, well, shouldn't he be in hospital? I mean, that's what pays my stamps for, a bung in hospital. I don't mind coming to see him, I don't.
I'm afraid not. You see, there really is a terrible shortage of beds.
I'll bang him on the floor then. If he's got a bad back, it's doing the world of good. A nice hard floor.
You don't seem to be very sympathetic towards him.
Oh, look, Doctor, I know him. He's not as bad as he makes out. You think he's ill. Believe me, you bang him in a hospital, stretch him on the floor, and he'll make the quickest recovery known to medical science. That'd be a miracle cure. Like them Filipino doctors.
It's out of the question. We only use hospital beds in an emergency. Besides, he'd recover much more quickly at home.
Ah, don't you believe it. Nobody's got me on the move. He'll be sitting up there like the Caliph of Baghdad, rubbing his bleeding lab and expecting me to appear in 5 minutes.
Arrow!
You are, he's got
that tree!
Coming, old great one!
Bring your turban on!
Hey, sure, there must be something you can do. I mean, can't you give him a shot of something? Like a .303? Have you tried acupuncture? I've got it in a gramophone needles out here.
No, the only remedy is rest and understanding. Now, as he gets older, this is going to happen to him more and more often.
Huh?
You're just going to have to face it. He's going to need constant attention.
You don't have to spell it out. I can see it all stretching out before me. I've seen it on the pictures. Poor, lonely, 40-year-old Jane Wyman, devoting her life to nagging, moaning, miserable Dame May Whitty. And on the pictures, somebody is to come along. Herbert Marshall, usually. He'd take her glasses off. She'd let her hair down. The old cow would kick the bucket and it'd all live happy ever after. Well, that's not going to happen to me. Nobody's going to let my hair down. It'll all bleed him full out before he's finished with me.
Well, I'll pop in again in a few days' time. In the meantime, this should ease the pain a little.
Thank you, Doctor. How many do I take?
For your father. These are sleeping tablets.
Aaron! Where's that tree?
You better give me some more. These won't last long.
Leave it to it then.
Come on, Doc.
And I'll call in again on Friday.
Yes, well, if I can drag myself to the door, I shall let you in.
Aaron! You don't care about me, do you? I'm ill.
Shelter from the stormy blast.
and crotch to lean upon.
Hello?
Ruth Summers.
Sir, was the champagne the caviar and pressed up, wasn't sir?
Where the bleeding hell have you been?
I'm terribly sorry, sir. There's been trouble in the kitchen. The wine waiter informs me that the Vive Clicquot 55 has run out and would sir mind making do with the PG tip 74.
Never mind about that all now. What did old Crippin say? Don't take no notice of him, he's a liar. I am ill.
Yes, I know.
Eh? What did he say?
Nothing. Now let's talk about it now.
What did he say?
Nothing.
What's wrong with me?
Nothing, nothing. Nothing to worry about. Look, just put it out of your mind. Forget it. You've had a good life. That's the main thing.
You're hiding something from me. What's wrong with me?
Don't think of the future, Dad. Think of the past. All those carefree golden days of your youth. The long, hot summers. Walking through the meadows, hand in hand. A pretty girl on your arm. The butterflies. The babbling brook. Oh, the scent of new mown hay. The smock farmers drinking from their jugs of cider as they lean on their pitchforks, taking a well-earned rest. The flowers.
What's wrong with me?
You're dying!
I'm not dying. I've got a bad back.
I'm sorry, Dad. I didn't mean to be the first to tell you. I didn't mean to let it out.
Take your tea quickly. What did he say?
He said, you've only got 3 days to live. Starting from now.
Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock, tick tock. Hey, you callous little cow rag. Oh, the agony. Oh. What did he really say, Harold?
He says you've got a bad back.
I know I've got a bad back.
Well, that shows what a good doctor he is, doesn't it?
I told him I've got a bad back. I want to know why I've got a bad back.
Lack of use. He said you've got to get out of bed and do the housework.
No, he didn't. He told me I'd have to stay in bed all the time, perhaps for weeks.
Oh, dear. Well, I don't know who's going to look after you, then.
Well, you are, ain't you?
Me? No. I've just come off the phone. I've been booking up my holiday. I'm going to Cornwall for the month.
Cornwall?
Yes. I'm going to do a bit of shark fishing. Bit of old surfing. Da-da-da-da-da-da.
Ya-da-da-da-da. Wipe out!
You'll not come with me, will you?
How can I surf? I can hardly surface.
Oh, shame. Well, is there anything else you want before I go and pack them?
You can't go, Harold. I can't move.
Oh, well, I'll tell you what I'll do then. I'll bring up some tins of food and I shall leave them on the end of the bed. You'll be able to eat some dinner, all right? Yeah. Cheerio, then. I shall send you a card.
I shall leave the front door open. The doctor can bring it out when he calls on Friday.
Dunno. See you next month.
Harold, don't leave me. I'm ill. I really am ill this time. I won't ask for much. Harold.
Oh, I got some bad news for you. I'm from the Cornish police. Your son Harold has been took by a man-eating pilchard. I might as well have been. They'll be eaten by a little sprat now anyway. Drink your tea.
Thanks, Harold. I won't be a burden to you, honestly. I know you've a lot to do. I know it's going to be hard on you, but I'm not skiving. Honest, I'm not.
I know, but I'm just mucking about. Just getting a few laughs in before it all turns sour. You better know what.
What else did he say?
Well, nothing more than what he told you. You've got some dish trouble in your back. You've got to stay in bed till he gets better.
Well, are you going to manage?
Oh, I don't know. Well, we'll manage. We always do.
You're a good boy, Harold. I appreciate it. Really, I do.
Is there anything I can get you?
No, I don't want anything. I don't want to bother you.
That's all right. I don't mind. What do you want?
No, I don't want to be any trouble.
I don't mind. What do you want?
I wouldn't mind another cup of tea. That one's cold.
Another tea. All right.
And Harold!
Yes, Dick?
Have the papers come?
Yes, Dick.
Could you bring them up with you?
Yes, Dick.
Oh, and Harold!
Yes, Dick?
Do you think you could make a little sandwich?
Yes, Dick. What do you want?
Oh, I don't mind. Anything.
Now, let's see. Corned beef?
No.
Cheese and tomato?
No.
Peanut butter and pickle? Well, what do you want, then?
Oh, know, anything. I don't mind. I could go and buy a sausage sandwich.
We got no sausages.
Couldn't you go out and get some then?
No, but... Yes, yes, so I'll go and get some sausages then.
Aaron. Aaron!
Yes?
Harold.
Yes?
I want to go to the lavatory.
Well, I can't do that for you. I'll get your milk bottle.
That's no good.
Oh, God! We ain't got a bedpan! Oh, that's fine. I'll go out and get one.
No, I can't use them. Never could use them. You'll have to carry me.
Carry you?
There and back.
There and back. Three times a day. Yes, all right. Yes, come on in.
Here we go. Little pony. Oh, okay. You're a good boy, Harold.
So you said.
Could you bring the television up and have the telephone?
Right.
After.
Yes, all right.
Could you go round to the library? I need some books changed.
Yeah, thank you.
And then later on, pop down to the off license and get some beer. Oh, be careful, you're hurting me.
I'm sorry. Thank you, mean how famous he is. Oh, God, I have an angel.
How are you? Oh, terrible. I'm in agony. Every time I move. It's been a fortnight now. Harold? Oh, he's hopeless. I haven't seen him for half an hour. All he thinks of is himself and pleasure. Eric and Arthur came round last night. Spent a couple of hours. Brahms and Liszt we got. Eric had a bird with him. About 50. Her husband's just died. You can guess what from the look of her. She's promised to come round sometime and duff up me pillows. Where's my bat? No chance. Oh, well. Cheerio. Seeing you.
Come. I'm sorry, Dad. I just come in from shopping. What do you want?
Racing at Kempton Park. That's all. I'll shout when I want you. Bring me books from the library.
Yeah.
Read it. You don't like him? Read it. That was a waste of time, wasn't it? I've nothing to read now.
Get some more, they don't close yet.
Yeah, well, take that tray down with you. I hate the smell of old food hanging about.
Did you like the steak?
Is that what it was? Terrible. Old gristle and garlic. You know I don't like garlic.
I thought it would bring out the flavour.
Well, it didn't. And it was fried. You know I like it grilled.
Well, the grill's broken.
Well, you can mend it, can't you? You're not hopeless, are you? And the peas were like bullets. If that's the best you can do, don't. I'd sooner starve.
I'm sorry, Dad. I'll do better tonight. I got a nice bit of fish.
I don't like fish. What is it?
Place.
Didn't they have no Dover sole?
They're about 30 bob a time.
If I'm not worth 30 bob when I'm ill, I'll make do with the place.
I'll get you a Dover sole then.
An arrow! Now what? Did you go out on the rounds today?
No, I didn't.
Why not?
Because, if you recall, I've been down the library, round the fish shop, up the off license twice, round the chemist, down the grocers, and in between I went up and down them stairs 23 times. And I'm not going out again.
Why?
To get 100 yards of rope.
What for?
I'm going to make a noose out of one end and put it around my neck. I'm going to put the other end in your end. And I would be grateful if in future you don't shout. Just pull. That's now you want me. Might even help me get up the stairs quicker. Believe me, them stairs, if you get it, look like the north face of the Eiger.
I see. It's wearing off, is it? I'm becoming a burden, am I?
No, right, but I've had a bigger one! But rest assured, I shall carry out my filial duties. And now, if you could please refrain from wanting anything for the next 15 minutes, I'm going to put my feet in water. Right. Stump!
Yes, I turned the volume on. Can't hear a thing. Oh.
Well, that's it. That old clothes knocking. That's fine.
I love them, I love them.
Good up an oaky. That's a lovely oaky.
I feel like a beer.
Oh, what's his life? Let's look out. We have no time to stand and stare. No time to see a beauty's glance and watch her feet.
And I can dance.
That's funny. Those two cans of lager were here this morning.
Well, I didn't have them. Well, I don't think the horse has had them. So that leaves that perpendicular ponce upstairs.
That also accounts for the gradual disappearance of all the pink ones in my licorice also.
Thank you.
kind of fool am I?
Harold, is that you?
Yeah, just give us 5 minutes then.
How are you feeling, Dad?
I'm not so good. It's getting worse. I think I'm going to be up here for quite a while, yeah.
Oh, I am sorry. This'll help you make you feel better.
Oh. Did you cook me something nice, Mitchie? Bacon, sausage and egg, is it?
Yes, you'd like that, wouldn't you?
Pickled onions and 4 slices of bread and butter.
Yeah, and 2 tins of lager and 1/2 pound of licorice also. Pink ones. You can have all of that later, but first... You're going to have a blanket, but... because you is a dirty little old man. I mean, you've been in bed for nearly 3 weeks now. And you haven't had a proper wash, have you? Here we go.
Dirty.
And that's important of all. We mustn't let you get bed sore, must we? Not a skinny little bum like yours. Surgical spirit. That is the thing.
To a grotto.